Hello world and welcome to the vlog. My name is Artemis and this is a space where you and I get to ask some deep questions about life. Chances are that you have noticed something in yourself, in your attitude, in the way that you respond to certain situations that you would want to change. Think about the goals that you have in your life and about the progress that you've made. If you were to map it out on a chart, would it look like peaks and troughs? Would it be a rise, a constant rise up, or a decrease? I think about that a lot. I look back on my life and I see a lot of peaks, a lot of troughs, some really deep ones. It seems like my troughs are a lot deeper than my peaks. I have this problem. I don't remember the sources of my information. I read a lot of random stuff and I watch just things that, you know, catch my attention or things that people recommend to me. Maybe reading a number of books at a time or listening to audiobooks and then reading another one. As much as I try to write things down to credit the authors, I seem to never remember who said what. I remember what they said, but I don't know who said it. I'm not trying to plagiarize or anything, but there's this thing about big starts. We all want a big start, you know. We want to find a bunch of money and invest into some big thing, a big dream of ours that we've always wanted to do. As it usually happens, big starts require big things, and we don't usually have access to big things, for the most part. So we don't start that often. Instead of waiting for something big and to start massively, we need to focus on starting small, on doing little things to continue. And better yet, we shouldn't stop at all. We should continue. It's that constant progression that will make changes in our life. It's, you know, if you think back to that map, the smoother the line, the better. If we never stop, if we keep that ball rolling, if we keep doing little things that will help us to reach our goal, that will help us to reinvent and to change things in our life. That is how we get ahead. As satisfying as it is to have a big start, to start on this dream project, it's never very pleasant to find yourself in a trough afterwards. The problem with the peaks are the dips that come after. Whether we like it or not, dips do happen, and they happen a lot more often than we choose to admit. When you're in a dip, it usually takes a long time to figure out what to do next, to set aside all the negativity, all the self-doubt, and everything that comes along with not getting to the result that you wanted from this big start. That's why it's so important to continue pushing your dream forward, pushing your projects every day and doing something to get the ball moving. Small everyday victories feel just as good as big ones. Being constant with your effort, being mindful of what your goals are, those are key elements here that we need to remember. And isn't it funny how the best practices in life and the best advice come straight out of the Bible? Jesus talked about it. The Bible is full of examples of how we need to be constant in doing the right thing, in seeking God and pushing forward our faith. And that's why I always say that success must go through God, because He knows what He's talking about. He wrote the blueprint for a successful life.